I'm G and you're watching G's Closet. Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm back with another review video, and today's review will be on this beauty, the Louis Vuitton cosmetic pouch in the PM size. So today's video will also be in three parts. The first part will be a small review of this beauty. The second part will be pros and cons of this cosmetic pouch. The third and the last part will be what fits inside this beauty. So before we go on to the video, if you are new here, welcome to my channel. My name is G. My channel is about luxury fashion, beauty and travel. If you are interested in videos related to these topics, do subscribe to me and help me grow my YouTube family. Subscribe to me by hitting that red subscribe button, and don't forget to hit that bell sign next to the subscribe button so that you guys will be notified whenever I upload a video. So let's jump into the review. Okay, to start with, let me give you the details of this cosmetic pouch. So this is the Louis Vuitton cosmetic pouch in the PM size, as I told you before. So the PM size is the smallest size. They do a GM size, which is the larger size to this beauty. So you can see this is the half moon styled pouch, and you can see it's just one canvas. It's made of one complete canvas, so you can see the Louis Vuitton logo is upright on this side, and when you just turn it around on the other side, it will be upside down. So when you actually turn the pouch onto the other side, the Louis Vuitton logo will be upside down. This is because it has used one continuous canvas to manufacture this beauty. And of course it has a zipper closure, and as you can see, there are two diamond shaped leather pieces on either sides. So these are untreated leather. Because this is in the monogram print, you get these pieces untreated, but as per the material, you get this in all three colors of the canvas: the monogram print, the Demier Urbain, and the Azure print. So in the Demier Urbain print, these leather tabs will be treated leather as usual. So in the zipper pull, you can see the Louis Vuitton logo engraved. It's in gold. So when you open the pouch, it is the brown interior. So the interior is also in leather. So this interior, the best part of this interior is it's washable, and you can see on one side you get this slip pocket, and on the other side there is nothing, guys. And it says on this pocket, it says Louis Vuitton Paris, made in France. So that tab is there. So this is untreated leather as well. Guys, you have to excuse my nails today. We are under lockdown, so I haven't been able to go and get my nails done. So please excuse my nails. So to give you the measurements of this pouch, lengthwise from this corner to this corner, when you measure it at the bottom, it's 19 centimeters, and the height is 14 centimeters, and of course the width is 6 centimeters. So if you talk about the wear and tear of this pouch, it has held up quite well, guys, because I bought this in 2015, if I'm not mistaken. So it has held up pretty well. It's been almost 6 years now for this pouch, and I have used this from the day I bought it, so it has been used quite a lot. I use this usually inside my bigger bag. So if you have a tote bag, it's very handy to have this pouch inside your tote bag. If you want to use your cosmetics, or if you want to use some of your items inside your bigger bags, this is a great pouch. I mean, you can hold cosmetics inside this, or even your miscellaneous items inside this pouch. So because this is in the monogram print, I have these untreated diamond shaped leather tabs. So these are untreated, so you know these leather parts will over time get into their honey colors. And inside, you can see, as per the wear and tear, these little stitching of the inside of the pouch has come off. I don't know whether you guys could see. So this doesn't really bother me. I mean, I have used this quite a lot, so there are like few stitches which had come off. And as per the interior, it has held up quite well. I normally use this as a cosmetic pouch, so I normally put all my lipsticks, eyeliners, lip liners and everything inside here. So it has held up pretty well. I even keep my compact powder inside this with a brush. It's held up quite well. You can see it's a little dirty, but it's not deathbed for 6 years, and I have been using this pocket to store my mirror. So it has stretched over time, so this is not a big bother for me as well, because I'm not planning on taking this as a little clutch bag. You can definitely take this as a clutch bag as well. And as you know, in Louis Vuitton, the zipper is the highlight of the pouches. So I mean, this zipper closure has held up pretty well. You can see it has got a little worn over time. It is not as shiny as it used to be, so that is completely acceptable, guys. And even the zipper on top, it has got a little dull over time, so this is perfectly all right with me. But the zipper of the pouch has held up pretty well. It's still quite smooth. You know how smooth the zippers are in Louis Vuitton, so it has held up pretty well. I mean, I love the zipper of these pouches, which Louis Vuitton does. So these are some of the wear and tear of this beauty. So let's go into pros and cons. So some of the pros of this pouch is the shape itself. I love this shape. It looks beautiful. You can use this as a clutch if you want to. I mean, I haven't done that. I have not used it as a clutch bag, but you can totally use it as a clutch bag. You can even insert a small strap into this and use it as a crossbody bag. So there are so many ways that you could use this pouch. So this is one of the biggest pros of this pouch. So I have one con for this pouch. So it doesn't hold as much as I want it to hold. So this is the only con I have. So this con is also because of the shape of this pouch. Because this is that half moon shape, you can't really stuff it up until it's full up to here. If you want to put any foundations, it might be difficult to store like a foundation, a liquid foundation bottle inside this beauty, because you can't keep it standing. Because of that, the storage inside this pouch might be a little difficult. But if you're just going to carry a compact powder and some lipsticks, this is great. So also another point is that you can store a lot of items like until half of this pouch. If you want to close the pouch with a lot of compact powders, and say if you have an eyeshadow palette, if you want to close it with all of that, it's going to be a little difficult, because you have to like sort of sort it out inside. Mostly when you stuff it and close the zipper, it might be a little crooked, and you might get dents in the zipper closure. So this is a bit of a con for this pouch. I will show you what fits inside this, and I will show you how you can organize it accordingly without getting any dents here. So if I quickly show you how it looks against the mini pochette, you can see the mini pochette is quite smaller than the cosmetic pouch. You can see this side by side, and you can see it together like this. So you can see the width of these two are quite different. Cosmetic pouch is definitely bigger than the mini pochette. I will do a separate video with a comparison of these two. Just for the size sake, I wanted to show you guys these two together. So that's how it compares to the mini pochette. So another con for this pouch is that because of its shape, because it is wider from the bottom, it is a little difficult to store inside mini bags, like smaller bags. If you are planning to insert this into a tote bag, it's totally possible. I mean, there is no problem in putting this inside a tote bag. But if you are to put this or carry it inside a mini bag or a smaller bag, it's going to be a little difficult because of the width of the bottom half of this pouch. So this is also one of the cons that I had. So that's about it for pros and cons. So let's see what fits inside this beauty. So first, I'm going to show you what I carry inside this cosmetic pouch. I actually use this as a cosmetic pouch inside my bigger bag. So firstly, I will need my mirror. So this will go inside the pocket of the pouch. So the mirror inside the pocket. And then I will need my powder, the compact powder. So this will go in as well. So I need my Real Techniques brush, the mini brush. So you can see there is more room here. So next, I will need my liquid eyeliner, which is from YSL. my Bobbi Brown lip liner, eyebrow pencil, this is from MAC, and of course my eyeliner pencil from Bobbi Brown. So all these I will need for my everyday purpose, so that will go inside as well, like so, you can see. So I will need a few lipsticks and a few other items inside here as well. So let me take a few lipsticks. So this is my MAC lipstick that will go inside as well, and this is a small sample lipstick which I got, so that will go in as well. So I will need my liquid lipsticks, that's from MAC as well, that will go inside. So there's another lipstick, a MAC lipstick from YSL, so a Dior lip gloss, my MAC lip pencil, and of course my lip balm from Chanel, and finally my mascara from Dior. So all this will go inside the cosmetic pouch perfectly. You can see how much it holds. It does hold quite a lot. So because I don't take a liquid foundation or any big bottles of foundations, I can use this as a cosmetic pouch inside my bigger bags. So you can see this can be closed without any problem. There are no dents here, so you can see it holds quite a lot. You can insert a bit more items in here, but I wouldn't do that. This is how I would carry this pouch. So let's see what else you can insert in here. So now I have a few lipsticks in here, but let's see if we could insert more lipsticks. So I have another big lipstick here, so let's put that in, and there's another MAC lip pencil. So you can see, guys, instantly it's getting filled now. So let's see if we could put this eyeliner as well. Guys, you can still close this without any problem. So now you can see there are a few dents here. So you can see when you arrange the items, the same items a little bit, and if you just arrange it after you close it like so, you can see the dents will just disappear. But guys, I wouldn't carry so many items inside this pouch, but it is possible to carry all your items here. So say if you need a little foundation stick, that can be inserted by reducing some of the items. Let's see that combination as well. So guys, if you need to carry a small foundation stick with a bigger brush, you can do that. So let's see how you can insert these into the pouch as well. So you can see you can insert a bigger brush and a foundation stick as well. The brush is going to be a little difficult, so you have to put it at the bottom like so. So let's see what else you can insert. I will need my compact powder as well with the foundation, so that fits in perfectly as well. Mascara, eyeliner, lip liner, and another eyeliner, my eyebrow pencil. So if you need your liquid eyeliner, that will fit as well. So you can still fit in some more items here. So a MAC lipstick, my MAC lip pencil, another lipstick, so my lip balm, and another lipstick from YSL. So let's see if we can insert these two as well. Okay, so now you can see it's going to be a little difficult to insert this particular lipstick, but I have inserted a few lipsticks and a foundation stick, my compact powder with the bigger brush. So you can see still it does hold quite a lot. Let's see if we can close this without any problem. Okay, that's it, guys. So you can insert a bigger brush and a stick foundation as well. So if you need to carry this as a cosmetic pouch, these are some of the ways that you could stuff this bag. So let's see if we could use this pouch for your miscellaneous items. So I have a hand sanitizer here, so let's see if that fits. It's quite a big bottle, and guys, it does fit here perfectly. And I have my key clay, so that fits in as well. So I will need my keys. So this is my 6-ring key holder that fits in with all the other items as well. So say you need your compact powder, your brush, your mini brush, and the lip balm. So let's see if we can insert these with all the other items as well. Okay guys, so you can see I have inserted a compact powder, a mini brush, my 6-ring key holder, my key clay, a lip balm and a hand sanitizer, a big hand sanitizer actually. So all that will fit in here as well. So let's see if we can close it without any problems. It's going to be a little tight because I have inserted a big hand sanitizer bottle. So you can replace the hand sanitizer with a smaller bottle, so then it will be easier to close. But I wanted to show you guys that you could use like a bigger hand sanitizer inside as well, so it does close perfectly. So let's see if we could use this beauty as an evening clutch. So if I'm taking this for an evening out, I will need a small wallet. So let's replace my wallet with this Chanel card case. So that can be fitted in here perfectly. You still have a bit of room. So say you need another spare set of cards, so that can go inside this key clay, so that will fit in perfectly as well. So I will need my keys, so again my 6-ring key holder. Guys, you can see it fits all these items perfectly. So with all these, let's see if we could fit inside the hand sanitizer bottle as well. You can see with the hand sanitizer it's going to be pretty packed, but still guys, it is doable. So you can see you can use this as an evening clutch as well. So let's see if we could insert a compact powder with all these items. So you can see guys, it's going to be difficult with the big hand sanitizer bottle. So I'm going to take off the hand sanitizer bottle. So if I take the hand sanitizer bottle out, you can insert your compact powder and you can insert your 6-ring key holder vertically like this. So it doesn't have to be horizontal, it could be held, it could be inserted vertically. So let's see if we can close this up now. Okay, it's going to be a little tight, but it is doable guys. So these are the combinations that you could fit inside this beauty. So I'm going to show you guys how this will fit inside other smaller bags. So let's see if it's easier to fit this in smaller bags. So firstly, I will show you if it fits inside my Lady Dior. As you can see, it's going to be difficult to fit the cosmetic pouch inside the Lady Dior simply because of its shape. Because it is wider from the bottom, it's not possible to put this beauty inside the Lady Dior. You can see the Lady Dior is quite delicate and it has a very narrow opening here. So because of that, this will not fit in here. If you want to know more details about the Lady Dior, I have done a separate video on this Lady Dior itself, so you can have a look at that. I will link it up here. So let's see if it fits inside the classic Chanel double flap bag. This is in the medium size, so you can see this is also going to be a little difficult. So even in the Chanel double flap medium size bag, it is going to be difficult to insert this cosmetic pouch. So let's see if it fits inside the Chanel boy bag. Because the boy bag has a bigger opening, it could be fitted sometimes. So let's see if it fits. Guys, you can see it does fit inside the Chanel boy bag. This is the medium size. So that does fit without any problem. But that's the only thing that you can fit inside this Chanel boy bag. So I wouldn't do that. But just for you to know, it can be fitted. So let's see in the mini pochette if this fits. Again guys, that could be fitted in the mini pochette in the middle compartment and also in the front compartment. No, actually front compartment is going to be a little difficult, so it can be fitted only in the middle compartment. So it closes off pretty well. So again, I have done a separate video for the pochette matisse as well. You can have a look at that as well. I'll link it as usual. So finally, let's see if the cosmetic pouch will fit inside the Gucci Dionysus bag. So guys, you can see it does not fit inside the Dionysus bag. So those were some of the smaller size bags which you could fit the cosmetic pouch inside. So now you guys will have a rough idea on how you can use this beauty. So it does fit perfectly in bigger bags, so I don't have to show you guys that. So that's it from me today guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and hope you guys learned something about this beauty, the Louis Vuitton cosmetic pouch in the PM size. If you have any more questions regarding this beauty, do leave a comment down in the comment section below. I will answer all your questions. And if you enjoyed the video, give this video a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, do subscribe to me by hitting that red subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell sign next to the subscribe button so that you guys will be notified whenever I upload a video. Also follow me on my Instagram, gscloset.lk. Hope to see you guys soon in my next video. Until then, have a great week and stay safe.